Hey guys, today's video is going to be one that I can solemnly swear, hand to God, that I never thought that I would do. It was recently re-brought up to my attention when I was reading chapters from my book for my audiobook. There's one chapter in particular that kind of struck a chord in me. So this story is basically going to be the time that I backed out of having a surgery. Usually when I set my mind to something, I just am committed and I follow through and I end up doing it, but in this case, the surgery was so intense and invasive. Like, I've been through some pretty scary things in my life surgically, but this just seemed so hard to overcome and intimidating and just like body mutilating. If something is like rooted with trauma, I usually tend to forget it. For example, when my mom passed away, there's months and months and months on end that I literally don't remember. My family or my friends will be bringing up things and I'm like, I don't remember that at all. I see the pictures, you guys are talking about the experience, but I don't remember it because I just kind of like block that out because it was such a hard time for me. So when I was reading the words on the page, a light bulb went off in my head. I was like, oh my God, there's more to this story. So what I'm gonna talk about is my sexual reassignment surgery. To begin, I had just finished writing my book. This is last year. And I remember feeling really, really strongly about having the surgery. I think I was finally feeling comfortable about it. And I've always had this kind of love-hate with the surgery. And like that will kind of in my mind, like complete me. And I feel like a lot of trans people feel that, and they feel like they're not done until they get the bottom surgery or whatever it is that makes them happy. But I feel like for me, I was in a very strong place. Sometimes I'll just get in these like phases where I'm like, now is the time and I'm finally ready, because after you get it, obviously there's no going back, which is why it's kind of such a mind fuck, because everything else I've achieved on my body is obviously irreversible. But for this, it just has this stronger pull in my brain, and I don't know why I go back and forth with it so much. And that's another reason why I wanted to just get this out there, because I feel like some people think that I'm the most confident trans girl in the world and I really don't struggle with things, but I think it is so important to just talk about this. Clearly there's heavy emotions there, and I just wanted to get it off my chest because I can imagine other people are feeling the same way. So finally, I just got the balls and I felt comfortable to call the surgeon and make an appointment with the doctor of my choice, the one that I had kind of had on my back burner in my brain for a very long time. One of my girlfriends years ago had her surgery done in Thailand. And I had always said to myself, whenever I get the surgery, eventually I want to go to that doctor, because she had explained to me that the technology is there, it's really, really advanced, and you're gonna get a really great result. And I would only wanna do this one time. For the love of God, I don't wanna get mutilated twice down there. A full on saw trap hostile experience. It literally even gives me like the fucking cold sweats even thinking about it. Contacting Thailand, by the way, is not easy. The numbers are like this long. You have to wait so long for them to respond. It's just a moment and a half to even like get it done. So the doctor got back to me, and I really did think, because I told him that I'm in California, I really thought that it would be one of those situations where it was like, okay, yeah, let's get on Skype and maybe send like photos or whatever. So he told me that I needed to come out for a consultation. Come out to Thailand, for sure. That's just not casual to me, you know? I've never been, and that's just like really far, just for like, hey Gorge, how are you? Will you do it? Yeah, cool. See you in a month. But needless to say, I totally understand, because it is such a big deal. So what I thought I would do is try to schedule the consultation, and then if everything works out fine and he is able to operate, maybe days later we could operate, so I don't have to go out there twice and I can just do it all kind of in one go. So at the time, basically nobody knew. I'm not even gonna front and say like, oh yeah, I just told a few people here and there. I literally think I told like two people that I was gonna do it, which is problem number one looking back. If I'm keeping this a secret, like looking at myself last year, I'm like, what are you doing, girl? You're keeping this big surgery, this happy, crazy experience and success in your life, you're keeping it a secret. So he gets back to me and we actually end up Skyping, and he is just this little Asian man. He is just such a doctor out of his mind. His English isn't like 100%, but I would say it was like a good 70. I'm not very good with accents. I was like, what did he just say? Let me just hope that he comes back with dates, or his secretary gets back to me with dates soon after our in-person consultation that he can operate on me, so I can, you know, have my plan and be out in Thailand for only one time. So I get an email from him like 2 days later, and I hear that his waiting list is like 6 months long. So in my mind, it's already a write-off. I'm like, I'm done with this. That's way too long. Just depressed. I was like, hey, this isn't happening for me. It's just not meant to be right now. But I kind of left it open-ended with them. I was like, oh, well, that sucks. You know, I was hoping for sometime in the near future, but if any cancellations happen and an appointment opens up, let a girl know. So I'm all scrambling. I'm looking at different surgeons, and I have a lot of friends who have gotten the surgery. I've seen a lot of vaginas, post-vaginas, and some are gorge and functioning, and some are not so gorge. Obviously, it goes without saying, I want a gorge, functioning vagina. It's not my fault I have a wide-set vagina. And no shade, and I'm not gonna name any of the girls, but one time I was at a house party and my friend who had had the surgery went in the bathroom in front of me. And when I'm telling you, she opened the door and a wall of smell and like fog hit my face from her using the toilet. And it's not funny because it's like, that was beyond her control, obviously. Something was going on down there. Literally for years after that, I thought that that's what a sex change would smell like. And if you know me, I'm like a really weird person with smells. Like I smell everything. If it's makeup, if it's food, if it's a fragrance, if it's shampoo. Before I even like analyze the packaging, I'm like, let me smell it. Cause if it doesn't smell good, I'm not gonna be able to get into it. But here's hoping that it was just an infection or something and she's all better now, hands to God, let's say. A little quick prayer for her. Okay. That is a real fear. You know, you're not really sure what you're getting yourself into with the surgery. So flash forward an entire month. I had narrowed it down to two doctors in the States that I was contemplating going to. I was talking to them, but I hadn't really decided to go to them. It was kind of just like an option. And I was hoping that this doctor in Thailand would hit me back. So my prayers were answered. And lo and behold, I get an email from him. And he tells me that there's a cancellation in 3 weeks. And I can come out, do my consultation, and if everything's fine and I get the green light, I can go through with the surgery and I just have to wait 3 weeks. So I'm legit over the moon. At this point, it started getting really, really real because like I said, I really hadn't told that many people. So I really had to start getting on that. And when I think about it, I really didn't reach out to as many people as I should have. I felt really, really inconsiderate about people who love me and want the best for me and would want to know if I'm going through with such a big surgery like this. So what happened was everything was booked and I went to Thailand with my friend and we are gagging. We land overseas and the next day we head to the facility to meet the doctor. And this is where my doubts started creeping in because the facility wasn't really what I thought it would look like. From what my friend had described and like images I saw online, it really did look like next level gorge. Literally as if I was stepping into the future. Like, hey, come get your surgery. Welcome to 2022. I was like, this is fine, you know, whatever. Maybe the medical facility is just so much more turnt than this. Maybe this is just like a little side moment for like their consultations. But no, so we did my consultation. He instantly, like literally within like 10, 15 minutes, let me know I was approved for the surgery and I was gonna get it in the next few days. So we go on this like tour of the whole building and I'm expecting it to get better. Me and my friend are giving each other eyes the whole time. I feel like I'm seeing tumbleweeds and like clay walls. We talked after and she didn't really know what to expect because I had never gone with her to any surgeries before. So she was kind of going off of me. I was looking at her like, Gorge, what is this? Well, after the tour is done, he walks us out and he's like, see you in 3 days. I was like, oh my God. So we're going back to the hotel and right away, I'm like, bitch, let's not even go to our room. Let's go to the bar. And we like beeline for the bar. Like 3 weeks ago, I was scrambling for surgeons and then this is just like happening. And we are fully in Thailand and this is like gonna happen within the next few days. Am I ready? Like literally, I was like looking down. I'm like, is this really the situation I want to happen? I was so unsure. It wasn't even funny. And I feel like if you're gonna do something like this, you should be fucking excited. You should be on the edge of your seat. Like, God, I wish I could fast forward 3 days. But at that point, I was like kind of dreading it. I kind of wish I had more time and I wasn't really in love with the doctor or in love with the facility or just like in love with how many people fucking knew I was even here. The whole thing was kind of a gag and I just like had felt like I was being bad and like running away and just doing this. So we sleep on it and the next morning, first thing I said to my friend, I was like, I can't do this. I can't do this. I haven't paid the full amount. I just gave the little down payment moment. We hadn't extended our flights yet either. So I was ready to back out. And my friend was like, what? I felt like yesterday you were just having like a little moment. You were dying because it was like all really happening. It was real. But if you really feel this way, then I have to like stick by you. So I call the doctor and I basically just let him know like, I can't do this. And I just need more time. And I tell him, I know you do great work and it's nothing to do with you. And one day, maybe I'll be back because I'm just not ready right now, girl. And it's just not looking good for my brain at this point to go through with this surgery because it's not something I want right now. Click. So I didn't go through with the surgery, and I'm really, really happy I didn't. I know my friend had a great result when she went to him, and I might have too, but it was just not looking good, not feeling good. All of the above was just like, this is not my moment for my life. Like, I should be more excited. I should have more people here, more people that fucking know. And even though there were funny, like, kind of cringe gag-worthy moments that happened on the trip, it was actually really sad and traumatic for me, because the way that I look at this surgery is such a huge moment for me and my identity and everything I've worked for years now. So I want it to be perfect. I don't want to feel all of the things I felt around that time. And the reason I wanted to share this story is I feel like with surgery and with being trans or wanting to change your body in any way, I feel like for me when I was doing it, it was like a race to the finish. Like, I couldn't get anything fast enough because I just needed it for, like, myself. Like, I just knew what I wanted and I was stubborn about it and just went for it. But where I'm at now in my life, and I've said this before, it's really not about the end goal. It's more about your journey there. And everyone's different, because it worked for me back then. I couldn't be happier with where I'm at now. But in this case, I definitely needed to wait and pump the brakes hard. And I don't know what my reassignment surgery story looks like. I'm just taking it day by day and in what feels right to me, because this is my body. I have to live with this every single day. And when that moment comes, I want it to be perfect. Oh my God, that was such a line that, like, someone says at prom. Like, but when I have sex for the first time, I want it to be perfect. I can't believe I just said that. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. And what made me think of this story, like I said, was reading my book, which is entitled He Said, She Said, which is available right now for pre-order wherever books are sold. And I'm gonna put the link down in the description so you guys can get one for yourself. Ugh, so rude. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. And until I see you guys next time, stay gorgeous.